You know, there's a really old song that we've been wanting to try for a while that Joe sings the shit out of. I'm hoping after we get some of these songs that we kind of have to play out of the way, then we can get Joe to step out and do a song for us. Sings the shit out of it.
Just like yours.
that makes any sense, then we're probably on the same wavelength. But yeah, that's where we're heading now. You ready? And then after that, I think if you can convince him. But if he, what? I'll play the shit out of the drums. I can play drums.
Hitting stuff with a stick.
I can do that. I've got two hands.
Ready?
Look at the world with bullets and guns at home to pass the time away. Careful fingers and eyes turn old, smoking a whole pint. Scars in the tadpole dust.
this song is a very special song for me because the person who wrote this song was, I met him when I was 8 years old in Steak and Shake in Atlanta, Georgia, and he told me that I, you know, could make a living playing music, which I really haven't, but he said, "Boy, I'm a rambling man, and you could be too one day. It's a good way to make a living." I swear to God, this is in a Steak and Shake. That man's name was Dickie Betts. This song is very dear to me, and it's kind of my you know, my personal anthem, if you will. So here we go. Take it away, Jimmy.
Story was really good. Did you really meet Dickie Betts?
Yeah.
When you were 8, you met Dickie Betts, really? You Steak and Shake. You just saw him? And your dad went, "Go, where's Dickie Betts from your own?" No, the 8-year-old's not going to know who Dickie Betts is. That's like an 8-year-old carrying one of those foam rubber things that you put around beer cans, like, that just has one. Beer cozy. Okay.
We're only gonna listen together. And all the shadows settle. The doors forced open shut again. The thoughts are up out of the pedal. My eyes were the claws rushing to fill them. And the morning after the night, I fall in love with the night. It is so clear I can arrive and realize I have my eyes. Stop the shrivel. When dreams made real become less sweet, they all get out of the middle. My six times of claws rushing to fill up. In the morning after the night, I fall in love with the light. It is so clear I can arrive without the fears in my eyes.
Thank you. option to always just go away. But there is an option to go inward. We take this opportunity then to go inward, to draw the senses inward, to watch perhaps how your body relaxes or does not relax. The fight or flight response of the nervous system seems to require more and more time due to the chaos in the outside world to actually relax. Being joined at the heart, back to back as you were a moment ago, can bring you to a space in the front of your heart to actually move forward into your life knowing that someone is right there always. And that then can give you access to perhaps a little more relaxation when you do have yourself a moment alone. You don't have to be like in your head. You could be at your heart. There is an opposite of samsara. Samsara, for all intents and purposes, is the word for continuing habitual habits, like a scar or a wound that keeps opening, same scar, again and again. We keep doing and saying the same habitual things and actually not paying attention to it. Quite frankly, we may never change. But what you want to get about not changing is that's why people love you. People love each other because we don't change. That is true love. Not expecting the change, but knowing that you are not responsible for changing either. Just responsible for your own well-being. So the opposite of that same scar, is when all the walls fall down and the cocoon completely disappears and we are totally open to whatever may happen, with no withdrawing, no centralizing into ourselves. That is what we aspire to, this warrior's journey. That is what stirs us, leaping, being thrown out of the nest, going through the initiation rites, growing up, stepping into something that's uncertain and unknown. What do you do when you find yourself anxious because your world is falling apart? How do you react when you're not measuring up to your image of yourself? Everybody is irritating you because no one is doing what you want, and your whole life is fraught with emotional misery, confusion, and conflict. What do you do? And at those times, it helps to remember that you're going through an emotional upheaval because your coziness has just been, in some small or large way, addressed. Maybe that's how it felt when you were back to back in this uncomfortable place of having to touch another human being. Maybe that's what it feels like to you to have the rug pulled out from under you. Turning it into that groundless feeling is a way of remembering that basically you do prefer life and warriorship to death. So no matter what it is that comes your way, and no matter what actually shows up on Thanksgiving or all the work that we put into it, can you actually change that four-letter word of work into play? Same four letters. Play with it. Relax with it. It will all turn out exactly the way it is supposed to. No kidding. If I asked you now, with your palms upward, to take everything that you truly love about yourself, because the universe